Degenerate things with our degenerate friends. Smoking too much and drinking from a bottle that never ends. Judging no one for nothing, don't give a damn about who you are. Every one of us with something that left us with scars.
to try to understand.
I was a different man. TSM.
What's up, guys? Tasteless and Artos is here for another day of the GSL Code A.
But this is not just any day.
No,
it
is
not.
GSL
Code A. This is like we are going to watch a legend play. We're going to watch very hot player play. And we are going to watch what could be the GSL Finals. Like,
yeah. We have four best of fives here today, so a longer day than normal.
You guys actually have to do your duty right now and let people know about this. And, you know, normally we try to figure out, okay, so there's, like, there's Twitter, there's, like, forums and stuff. You can post on your Facebook, your Instagram. You know, sometimes we ask you to send smoke signals or carrier pigeons.
This time we need you to open up the window and just start screaming.
Yeah, start screaming
start
out the window.
Screaming. The GSL Code A is on. We're going to have a fantastic day, a long day, a lot of good games. And it's a real treat because it's not just more StarCraft II than a normal day. Mm. It's more extraordinary players than we would normally ever have in a Code A day.
Yeah, it's pretty insane. Normally, like, multiple of these players would be in the top eight and get seeds. Not the case this season. So, I mean, this is a big deal. Think about it hard, guys. Like, just in case when you were born, you were actually an identical twin and you have a mental bond, but you were switched, like, taken away at birth.
Yeah.
Think hard so that you can re-find that identical twin. At least one of you probably has that happening.
That's right. At least
statistically,
one.
Definitely.
There's enough people that watch this, so yeah, maybe the babies were swapped.
Like one was
the
stolen.
Baby room or whatever that's called in the hospital.
Yeah.
And you have a twin somewhere. Think hard, connect with them, because today
meet
is
up
going
with them
to
in
be
Twitch
pretty
chat.
Good.
Yeah, no, this is an insane day. I'm so excited about. It. We have a sick crowd down here today as well.
Yeah, it's quite
just
packed
great
in
matches.
Here, actually,
great matches, great players,
and it's been a busy week for you and I.
Yes, indeed.
You've been casting a lot
Cast
of Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah.
I've been over at SPO doing Pro League, and I'll be doing SSL tomorrow. So we got a lot of StarCraft,
yeah.
A lot of esports happening throughout the weekend.
A lot of great matches at Pro League. I got to watch them all this morning. And, of course, we just had IEM Taipei.
Which was awesome. Congratulations, SOS.
Yeah, pretty cool stuff. I'm going to watch those games tomorrow. Had a like
it was,
a
it was
marathon
hard for me to
session
keep up with.
Of Pro League this morning, man. Oh, my God.
So much StarCraft going on right now. And speaking of IEM Taipei, Beyond getting second place.
That's right.
Yeah, he's here in our first match.
Even took out Sulky 3-1. So Curious definitely going to have his work cut out for him. And don't forget, Beyond in the SSL actually took out Sue 2-0 also. So Byun, you know, he's been killing basically since Legacy of the Void beta has come out. He's continuing to do so, but Curious has become a serious player recently.
He has.
He's no longer the gatekeeper. He's the guy now.
He's the guy. Everybody wants to be the guy, but he is the guy.
He is the guy. It's,
and we'll have to see how well he actually does here now. He's always been around as long as StarCraft II has been televised. Curious has been there. And we're kind of waiting to see, will he ever actually, let's say, get to a finals or become a champion?
Yeah. You know, he did so fantastically last year. I'm really looking forward to seeing what he can put out this year. He just played in Pro League against Classic in what was one of the better macro PVZs that we've seen in Legacy of the Void. So, like, he's really on a high level to be able to fight tooth and nail against Classic, who is definitely one of the very best players in the world right now.
All right, we're going to be starting our first match shortly here.
Look at that crowd.
Look at those beautiful people in the crowd.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, we love you guys. We love you guys at home, too. You guys are always welcome to come down to our studio and join us. I like that sweatshirt, by the way. What is that on the sweatshirt? Is that a face? Is that me? Is that my face? Is that
yes.
Me with a beard and really clean teeth?
No, it's a guy with a beanie on, I think.
Is it? You know what it is, actually. It's one of those things where you can look at it upside down and it's something else all of a sudden.
Oh, wow. I think you might be right about that.
Yeah.
You're like that, actually. When I look at you, normally your taste is, and when I look at you upside down, your taste is upside down.
Yeah, that's right.
It's something totally different.
Anyways, nice sweatshirt. Byun doing very well. He had a strong showing early on in Wings of Liberty. And,
he was in the very first season.
That's right.
And in fact, the second season, he actually very, very narrowly defeated Artosis because Artosis had no detection.
That's right. My God, I forgot about that. Yeah. You played against this guy.
He was actually a Protoss player, and I was a Zerg player, and I had four bases, and he had two. Oh, man, it was so heartbreaking. But very good player, especially when he switched over to Terran.
Could have been you being second place at IEM Taipei if that day hadn't gone that way.
Oh, I don't think so.
Here's Curious. Curious, fantastic player. He's always been around. He's always been one of the standard players you'd see in CODES, but not somebody who was necessarily getting to the finals. Kind of like Keen, but maybe a little bit of a better version
of
that. Yeah,
definitely. I would agree with the better part. He's a really strong Zerg right now. His play has just kind of come together, and now with this solid sponsor, Inafrica, the greatest esports company on Earth.
That's right. Saving esports.
Again and again. And it will continue to do so.
That's right.
Until all other sports are dead but esports, which has been saved by Inafrica.
Until we've stopped all other forms of sporting and only esports remains, we will not stop here at Inafrica. It is a best of five, so a lot of time for these guys to not only prepare but to also adjust as the games go on.
Mm-hmm. It looks like both the new maps have been taken out by these two. Not too surprised to see that. Byun being on X Team, not like a Kespa team or anything like that. Probably gets the vast majority of his practice on the ladder. So,
very true.
Going to be playing ladder maps here tonight.
We're going to start out on Ruins of... Tell me, how do you say this map? You say Ruins of...
Saris?
Okay. Yeah.
Why else would you say it?
I think I said Seross,
actually.
Seross? How do we officially say this?
Welcome to...
Anyways, guys, we're beginning our first best of five. We have a lot of games tonight, four best of fives total. We're starting off kicking ass here with Byun against Curious. In the bottom right, in the blue, he is
X Team Byun.
There he is. The legend.
The legend. With a cough. In the upper left, in the red.
Africa Prix, Curious.
And the crowd goes wild.
Two times.
No cough here for Curious. Good condition.
All right. So.
Sorry, I have to break the fourth wall here. Which of these dials turns up the volume in my headphone?
Yeah, mine was really low, too.
Mine's really low. I can actually barely hear you. Is it this one here? Check, 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 check. Okay, now. Oh, this is great. Okay. I guess they used this desk another day when we weren't here for probably some other broadcast.
Someone left their glasses on my
seat. Yeah, there's a mystery set of glasses.
So I sat on them. Like, that's my seat. yeah. So.
Let me see those, actually.
Yeah?
Let's be careful. They're nice pair. I just want to see how I look with these on.
Let me see.
Might wear these on.
Oh, wow. Look at this. Some carbon drawings here. Oh, those are way too small for you. You look like my grandmother that took those out of her purse to read something that
really?
Was too small. Yeah.
I don't look like I
those do not fit
am
your
suddenly
head.
A computer hacker or...
No.
Okay.
Those are like just way too small for you.
Good thing I got good vision then.
Mm-hmm.
All right. The game has begun to pick up here. We have a Reaper build coming out for our Terran player with a quick command center Zerg. Somewhat similar build, somewhat similar idea. Just going for an hatchery, getting a few lings out here with speed. And this is the dance we'll probably see done for some time here in Legacy of the Void. This seems to be the way to open.
Yeah, as far as Zerg goes, you're basically always going to see, against Terran at least, like a hatchery first into a gas and pool, just so they don't die to anything like... For instance, if someone goes like a 3-Rax Reaper, you're going to need to get that speed out relatively quickly. And this is just like a very safe build from Curious. Taking a look at the map and the spawning positions being cross spawns here.
This is, I believe, out of all the maps we have, this is the farthest distance.
Yeah. It takes a long time to walk across here. And that could be very good for Curious, especially depending on what type of style he wants to play. We've seen recently... A style that I think is going to take over for Zerg versus Terran.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, some Zergs have been popping up with it. Like, for instance, we've seen Dark doing it. We saw it a few times in Pro League this week. It's basically where you kind of go, like, some Ravagers and Lings into, like, a few Infestors and kind of turtle up to Ultras. and just go for like kind of late, super late game type of army. You just kind of try to go up to Hive on four bases.
And just power up and really fill out that tech tree.
Yeah, if you can manage to stop the drops from hurting you too much, it really gets you into a nice position in the late game as Zerg. And I do think that Zerg has the... Ooh, that was really nice.
So good. That was so good.
Yeah, really good micro by both sides there. But yeah, I think that in the Supreme late game, Zerg has the advantage. So I'd love to see Curious go for that here in these super far away spots.
We see the Hellions backing up. And one thing I want to point out, because we saw a little bit of this in the 2 days I casted a Pro League before this, we want to keep our eye on the Zergs and how well they can keep their Ultras paired with the Lings. We had a couple games back there where Ultras were just gunned down.
Yeah.
Because the Ultras alone are actually horrible units. If you just have one Ultra or even four Ultras, they're actually pretty bad. I know that might sound weird, but I mean, you can kite them as Terran. You can stim and run away and basically out-micro them forever. So you need to have them with your Ling. So let's keep our eyes peeled for that. We have Hellions coming up here now. The drones have not all been pulled just yet.
Yeah, very nice Hellion drop here. Getting a few drones already. Curious trying to do his best to split here. Lining up some of these drones, though. Already six going down.
And it looks like he's actually zoned it. Well, hold up. Okay, no, he's going to pick up now. No drones to drop at this expansion.
And, okay, so lost seven drones, but a little counterattack here with some Zerglings. Doesn't look like it's going to do too much.
Yeah, this should not be too impactful right now. The Lings do come up now. And, yeah, that's going to be cleaned up pretty easily. I don't know if that was ever going to do anything. I mean, the number of Lings coming out, that was always... Well, hold up.
Yeah, there's
he's sending
a
all
lot.
Of his roaches here. And
there's like 30 more Lings on the way. So this is a pretty big deal right now. In fact, he can even make some Ravagers as he pushes forward with this.
Now, we don't have a bunker set up just yet. He's making one. These depots are going to be exposed, and Terran is actually close to being maxed out here. So he might even be able to take those out on the way up there. And possibly, he might even want to just jump on the bunker. Let's see how he handles this.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty tough to hold. And here he comes. Those Ravagers are going to be following him up pretty quickly here. Going after that bunker right away. Doesn't want that to finish.
Now, he can actually hit the siege tank over here from the low ground with corrosive bile if he chooses to attack that there. And it looks like instead he wants to actually crack open the ramp.
It looks like not quite able to crack up. Really good micro there by Bjorn, blocking vision of that high ground. So making it a bit harder for Curious to actually break through this situation.
Yeah, nicely done. I thought he was going to be able to edge his way up there. But he's going to go ahead and continue to press on this. Now, the tank is on the low ground, but obviously when Legacy, you can just pick that tank up immediately and drop it right back up onto the high ground if the Roach Ravager army does try to re-engage it.
Taking a look at this now, it is going to go into macro play here from Curious. Like, that is a move that could have killed Bjorn, but instead, you know, he killed some buildings, he killed some units, got a decent amount of SCVs there. And now it's just time for that macro play, and I think that Curious is far enough away that he should be fine transitioning into this.
Yeah, I think you're correct. He definitely put the pressure on there. He did get a few SCVs, and it caused them to pull. And this is actually pretty common for Zerg in general in all matchups right now in Legacy, as we see a lot of timing attacks with Roach Ravager.
Yeah.
I think that will probably reduce as the year goes on, but right now that's just very common.
Well, I think it's something that we're especially going to be seeing a lot of in Protoss versus Zerg right now with the changes to Photon Overcharge.
Yeah.
That's going to be something that we're seeing, like, a little bit of volatility in that matchup while Protosses reconfigure how to hold on against all sorts of various early attacks. But definitely still something that can be very useful here.
Also, with the tanks coming out, this is something we've been seeing more and more of. People are treating tanks a lot like Brood War players treated Reavers. So they just come up here, and because you can drop them and they'll immediately deal damage, you can just harass like this.
Yeah,
and
this
it's
is
kind of crazy just how much damage you can actually do. You see nearly taking out that queen.
Look at this, and yeah, I mean, he's going to get this one. It's pretty awesome. We do have these Ravagers coming over to add some damage in.
Oh, got to be careful.
Really good micro by both sides.
If he loses this medevac, it's bad.
Yeah, that's really expensive.
No kidding.
But, okay, so that was actually a really fantastic defense by Curious. It was good harassment by Bjorn, but he actually, at the end of the day, doesn't really get that much done with it. TY would have probably killed Curious with that.
Yeah, TY would have already destroyed at least two bases with that.
Yeah.
You saw that game, right?
Oh my God.
It was just like so crazy. Good. All right, so we have 1-1 finishing here for Taren, and Stim is almost done. So we can assume coming up here that Taren is going to be pushing out, and it looks like he's already going to go. Now that he sees that he's cleared up the spot,
yeah.
He might as well get those soon-to-be Stimmed Marines over outside the entrance here of Curious's base.
That's right. He's definitely going for a bit of a push here. 1-1 going to be finishing pretty soon for Curious, but it's a bit later than Bjorn's. And he does have Mutas on the way as well as Baneling Speed. So just a standard Mutaling Bane after this Roach Ravager initial opening.
Okay, he's coming forward now. You can always utilize the high ground, low ground positioning when you got Siege Tank, Medivac combo together. It's pretty scary. Interestingly enough, though, Taren decides to back off. Bjorn does not want to overcommit, or at least it seems so far. Oh, maybe I spoke too soon. All right, he is going to start pushing in here. And the Mutas are done. They are out. So this is going to be a little bit scary.
This is definitely where he has to be very careful. You know, if this was not a Spire-type build, this would be much less scary. You could always get away. But with these Mutas here, if he ends up losing too many Marines, a lot of Siege Tanks and Medivacs could be hunted down.
Okay, he's continuing to come forward now. And he's slowly edging behind where the drones are, actually. He's going to get some good kills. Oh, we just caught the drop over here in the upper right.
Yeah, very nice. He does have to go clean that up and does end up getting 9 drones with his actual frontal push here. But that Baneling Speed is done, so he might have to run out of here pretty soon. This is a long map, and he can't boost all the way home if enough Banelings come in.
Yeah, actually, the problem with he has Siege Tank sieged up like this is he has to actually run home.
Mm-hmm.
He can't just pick up everything and boost out, or he's going to lose those tanks. And you really can't lose tanks in TBZ. It's going to be the beginning of you actually getting too behind here. We see the Marines stimming, starting to run back. Banelings coming down here and connecting, and there's just not enough. But now I see reinforcements coming up from the bottom right. Zerg splits and backs up.
Yeah, that was a good thing his reinforcements are coming. We would have lost a lot more, but does end up losing a couple of siege tanks, which is a little bit annoying, but he's going to go ahead and transition into more of a Widowmine heavy composition as we see from this Drilling Claws upgrade.
And this is something I'm wondering if we're going to see Taren do more, is switching in between techs.
Hmm.
You can go from Widowmine, you know, even having some Thors in there, Marines pushing, and then switch back into tanks.
Yeah,
there's a lot of different ways you can play this. So
it's, you know, the siege tank is going to be much better against things like Roach Ravager, which are, you know, that's a very strong composition. A lot of Zergs are doing it right now. But against something like the Mutaling Bane, I mean, Widowmines are still absolutely fantastic.
Yeah,
so very
sure.
good to see him switching it up into that and even adding some Thors in here as well.
Also, I just want to say, really excited to see Bjorn down here today and see that he's actually doing quite well. I love it when we have players that have been around for a long time but kind of fell off the wagon coming back and actually having some solid performance.
Yeah, it is very nice.
This is no weak opponent, by the way. Curious is serious business.
Yeah, absolutely he is. Like, if Bjorn beats him here, that's a big deal. He's already in that round of 8 in the winner's bracket of SSL. Just got second at IEM Taipei, and here he is fighting for a Code S spot against someone that has just been fantastic recently.
Taren's continuing to push out. Zerg already maxing out. We see additional Banelings being made. That's pretty common. Right when Zerg hits that max out point, that's when you blow up with a bunch of Banelings.
Mm.
Taren has done a decent job in preventing the Zerg's creep from moving too far out.
Yeah, that's definitely something that's pretty important here if you can keep
that
creep back. If you get that too far out as Hive is coming, like if the creep is like halfway through the map and your opponent has Ultra Ling, you can't kill him. You are not going to be able to push in and kill
this. Yeah, I mean, you have to stay out on the edge of the creep and slowly push that back. Mm-hmm. But Zerg is just so strong when actually on that creep. And we see him pushing forward here now. Some nice connections there with the siege tanks.
Yeah. Look at this. Thor kind of way out of position up there. Going to be picked off very easily.
Well, I guess it sort of worked out. What?
Okay.
My eyes. Oh.
Well, that was a mistake.
That was horrible.
Oops. Well, there's a lot going
whoopsies.
On in Legacy of the Void.
Yeah, a lot more multitasking.
Well, still a very scary army up here. Continuing to push. He is going to have 3-3 pretty soon here, but we will have 2-2 for Curious, so not as bad as it could be, I guess. Ultra's Cavern on the way, as well as Adrenal Glands. And it looks like...
Sorry, I was drinking water. Yes, I'm still here. Muta's now coming in here. He's going to be hitting this Liberator. The Liberator does go down. Another Liberator to the left and more Marines to the right, but so far that hasn't actually been dealt with. Terran doing a push over here towards the upper left, and I think with this nice spread and the Muta's out of position, Terran should be able to take out these hatches.
Yeah, and that's pretty important. That's like a bottleneck area, but he does have a huge amount of units in the back here. And he's kind of spread. He wasn't really expecting to be an attack from this angle, I think. The siege tanks having Lings get on them right away here. And it looks like Curious will easily clean everything up.
Yeah, you can see Terran was actually set up to be hit from above there, from the top part of the map. But yeah, when Zerg came in from that odd angle, everything that Beyond had got destroyed pretty quickly. However, the supply lead's still going to Beyond. He's continuing to harass. I think we're really seeing the fundamental burden of Terran in cross spots on this map. It's really hard to push and actually break the Zerg.
Yeah.
The travel distance is too strong and Zerg can too easily spread creep.
He definitely gained a nice advantage there, killing a ridiculous amount of drones. So, I mean, overall, this worked out pretty well for him. But the game is not over yet. Beyond has taken his fourth base. He's going to have to continue to macro up, work on this composition. Whereas better and better upgrades are coming in for Curious now.
Zerg beginning to come down. It's a lot easier for Zerg to hit these bases and possibly take them out just because Zerg's movement is so fluid. It does harass those SCVs and then just goes ahead and backs up again. Zerg also expanding to the center left now.
Yeah, a little bit low on SCVs here, I guess, for Byun, but as he mines out of his main and natural, not that big a deal. Still keeping his economy on a solid 2.1 bases or so.
2.1?
Yeah, something like
2.3 repeating. Well, I'll get to that in a second. Okay, the Mutas have been driven out. I want to point out that any other base from here for Terran to acquire is actually incredibly difficult. Mm-hmm. So there's a bit of a timer here. Terran can't expand, you know, generally, and look, I know we have seen exceptions in StarCraft 2, but if we could just speak in generalities, like, it's very tough for Terran to get further and further out on the map and secure the places at bases, excuse me.
Yeah, the huge, like, he has a very mobile army right now, but he's going to Liberator tech, which makes a lot of sense, of course, against the Ultras that are coming out, but the mobility of this Ultralisk-based army and the strength of it on the open ground as Byun moves across the map cannot be denied, so this is a tough situation for Byun to actually finish Curious off in. Like, right, he has more army supply, but I don't think there's any way Byun's going to kill him anytime soon.
Yeah, I'm not sure. We have a small attack coming up here again. Ultras alone, generally not that strong.
He should turn those around.
He should
actually
attack those. Yeah, I'm a bit confused.
He's just there's too much going on right now. A lot of Ling harassment down at the bottom. Does turn around to kill off these Ultras. And those are kind of free right there.
I think Byun's kind of falling apart here in the last minute or so.
Well, looks like, luckily for him, he does have this drop going on. I guess it doesn't get too much done. Yep. He does lose that command center. Ouch.
I got to say, surprisingly, Zerg was not hitting the bottom. There, in fact, were not turrets. There was no anti-air there. I don't even believe there were widow mines there. Oh, my God.
That's a lot of widow mines.
Yeah, no kidding.
But
right now there's only one, I guess, proper base that's functioning here for Terran. That's close to the bottom center, a little bit to the right of it.
Mm-hmm.
This base is going to be mined out in the next minute or two here, the one that we just had a shot of.
Yeah, it definitely does look that way. But in the meantime, I mean, Curious, he's mining out of his third. His fourth base is still totally fine and healthy. He doesn't really have a lot of drones at his fifth base, nor does he have anything in front of it to see any incoming drops or attacks. So that's something that Curious is going to have to look out for. If Byun finds a way to actually abuse that fifth base, that definitely could lead to a victory.
Yeah, let's see if that actually turns out to be the case. The Mutas are coming down now. Again, no defense here. It doesn't really matter if the base is taken out so much as how many workers are going to be killed off. Terran already pretty low at a 36 SCV count.
Well, the Mutas doing good work here, really utilizing how big of a map this is to their advantage, so quickly moving around and harassing. We do have some ghosts coming out for Byun, and, like, okay, so ghosts with snipe can do quite a nice job against Ultras.
Yeah, this and is, I think, like, the finale tech here for Terran.
Yeah, yeah, it's kind of interesting because, like, okay, you can go for ghosts, you can go for Liberators. How do you want to really deal with this? That hurt. The thing is, there's no infestors out for Curious, so interrupting the channel of, because oftentimes we see people just like try to fungal the ghost so that interrupts all the channels and they can't get their snipes off. We don't really have that here. So if he utilizes these ghosts really well, this could work out for him.
Let's see. I think, again, though, the larger issue here for Taren is the fact that it's nearly impossible to stamp out these new bases. For instance, let's take the center left. How is Taren ever really going to push that?
Yeah, no,
I mean, that's really tough, man.
And, you know, on top of that, it's like this Ghost tech, I have, like, a lot of thoughts about using Ghosts against Zerg right now. And one of them is it feels like it's a very defensive unit.
That's what I was going to say, because the fact of the matter is that you're not going to be running around the map killing everything with Ghosts. You're basically holding off hordes of Zerg units. And this doesn't get any harder for Zerg as they continue to expand on the map. It's pretty easy, pretty straightforward.
But, yeah, it's like if he tries to walk out on the map with an army that has a bunch of Ghosts in it to kill the Ultras, that can go so wrong so quickly.
Oh, yeah.
Whereas, like, for instance, if he's sitting back at his base and he's, like, got the Ghosts kind of in interesting locations behind buildings and stuff, I feel like it seems to me that the Ghosts are just going to be a little bit better defensively. So I'm torn. I don't think Byun really has any way to kill Curious in this game. Like, I think he needs to take more bases and just get, like, a sick maxed army and take some good engagements.
We see, once again, chasing the Mutas. Taren trying to push out. To what you were saying, yeah, I almost feel like there's not a way for Byun to win, only to make the game go on for longer until maybe an opportunity arises. And that's going to be pretty strain on him. I mean, a best of five, fatigue is a factor here.
Yeah.
And playing from this fundamental disadvantage for a long time can make it a pretty tough game number two, to be completely frank.
That's very true. I'm interested in this move right here, okay? He just dropped and killed off the sixth base. That's a big deal. Like, I see this on the mini-map happening right now. In the meantime, that fifth base I was talking about with nothing in front of it to spot, he's actually going to get it. Look at this.
This is because the Mutas didn't turn around.
Yeah, he didn't have adequate scouting or creep spread in front of this base, which, I mean, this is the craziness of Legacy of the Void. You get so much going on. Like, Curious just had nothing down there. He didn't even know this attack was really coming, and now Byun has sniped his bases, and Curious is barely mining.
Well, he's driven back some SCVs, and now we're seeing in the almost top center, Taren's also actually secured, or wait, hold on, there's actually a huge attack going on over there, so scratch that. We're seeing, it looks like Zerg will be able to expand there.
Yeah, some nice snipes going down on these Mutalisks.
Yes.
Getting a few kills there. Good amount of Widow Mines, but yeah, he needs to pull back into kind of a defensive stance here. This is a very interesting game that we're watching because they're both really far away from each other, and anyone that plays very defensively here isn't going to die most likely.
That's true. My concern is that Zerg can still just expand again.
Yeah.
And we're talking about a Zerg that has nearly double the supply of his opponent. So, I mean, there's still a lot more room to maneuver around here as a Zerg player.
And he's about to have 3-3 for his melee, which is pretty crazy. Looks like he does get another snipe off there. That Mutalisk count getting lower and lower and lower.
With these Mutas, he can keep the Taren constantly running back to defend, since Taren is running off almost empty right now. Mm-hmm. Massive amount of Ultras and Banes. We do need to see some more Lings with that if it's going to be effective. You need to get those surrounds so that the Ultras can actually engage and do the damage.
You know, this is part of the beauty of the way Legacy of the Void was made. Like, with the old economy of, like, the you don't have to expand as quickly, he could have a lot of Lings, but he doesn't really have the minerals to afford Lings right now, which makes this composition a lot harder to make. And yeah, you're right. I mean, he's, oh man, just blows those up, but he doesn't really have a lot of stuff to tank here.
Yeah, every Taren unit is so precious right now. If he loses anything, it could be at the breaking point here. Baneling's now coming down here. Nice connections, but keeping those Ghosts alive is Byun.
Yeah. Very, very important right now. If he gets those snipes off, he can win this game.
All right,
but
here
this
we
is a lot
go.
Of units. Oh, man, and this is, well, he's getting some snipes off, it looks like. But
yeah,
we
but
do
the fungal,
have fungals coming.
The fungal connection. The fungals can make up for what the Lings, when the Lings aren't there. That's going to be a GG.
All right.
Byun losing game number one. Curious, your winner, guys.
All right, yeah, that was a very interesting game. You know, when you're that far away, it becomes pretty difficult to kill the Zerg on those cross spawns. Byun had some really great moves, but you know, Curious harassed him a fair amount, and Byun never did, like, really even try to get a fifth base. And you're right, it's very hard to take a fifth there against Zerg. But
it really is.
But there wasn't much of a way with that composition for him to walk across the map and actually end the game.
I didn't see any way he could do it. I mean, this has always been a bit of an issue when you have a map that's that disproportionately big.
Yeah.
Especially in cross spots, because Zerg actually have two directions they can expand. So if things aren't working out on one side of the map, no big deal. You just go to the other side.
Yeah. Well, looks like we are going to go to a very different map coming up next.
Orbital Shipyard.
Definitely going to be easier to take some of those additional bases, and definitely not as long of a walk either. So very much looking forward to this next game.
Let's see if Young can come back. He did play very well, but, I mean, on a map like that, it's pretty brutal, man.
Yeah, it's guys, get out there, let your friends know. Code A is on. The GSL is here.
Join us. Become one of us.
Join us or die.
This is a GSL Code A Game 2, Beyond Against Curious. Let's go. In the upper right, in the blue.
X-Team, come.
Does that make him an X-Man?
Sorry, what?
He's on X-Team.
Oh, yeah. Okay, well, he's Cyclops superpower? Then. There we go. In the bottom left, in the red.
Africa Prix, curious.
All right, well, we do, again, just if you look at the way this map's shaped, yeah, sure, I mean, it is.